The Feeding Our Future Child Nutrition case is now at the center of Minnesota politics. The Republican candidate for Governor Scott Jensen today once again called for the resignation of the state education commissioner, asserting her department should have uncovered the alleged fraud sooner. There's also a lot of back and forth about what a Ramsey County judge did or didn't order the department to do. John Croman joins us with more on the latest developments. Hi, John.
Hey, Kent, you know, the narrative since last January when the Star Tribune first reported the FBI's investigation into Feeding Our Future, the narrative was that the judge ordered the Minnesota Department of Education to continue making payments even after state employees suspected fraud. The judge himself now says the media got it wrong last January and ever since then, and the governor was wrong to repeat that. But the story's not that simple.
What did Governor Walz know? When did he learn what he knew? When did he decide to use a district court judge as a scapegoat?
Scott Jensen, the Republican who wants to replace Governor Walz.
My name is Heather Mueller.
Again, saying that the governor should ask for Education Commissioner Heather Mueller's resignation because of the Feeding Our Future child nutrition fraud case.
Who is he trying to protect? Is he trying to protect Heather Mueller, who clearly did not get the job done?
Governor Walz has stood by Commissioner Mueller, pointing out that it was her staff that first tried to stop payments to Feeding Our Future after detecting possible fraud in 2020 and eventually got the FBI involved.
The fact of the matter is it was our administration that caught it. We caught it early. We asked for help. We didn't get it. The courts ruled against us. We complied but still pushed this. We got the FBI's involvement, and this week we got indictments.
Walz was referencing something that's part of the Department of Education and the FBI's narrative of the case, which has been widely reported, that Ramsey County Judge John Guthman compelled the MDE to resume payments to Feeding Our Future.
The evidence to me was overwhelming. I wouldn't have believed in a million years that they were going to rule that way. And keep in mind, they walked right up to, and this group celebrated, that the commissioner could be going to jail if she doesn't pay us.
A day after Governor Walz said that, the courts issued a press release saying Judge Guthman never ordered the Department of Education to resume payments, that the media and Governor Walz were all mistaken on that count.
All of the Minnesota Department of Education food reimbursement payments to Feeding Our Future were made voluntarily without any court order, the statement said.
But the Department of Education countered with transcripts of an April hearing in which Guthman tells the state's lawyers they can't stop approving applications for new feeding sites. The regulation doesn't allow you to withhold payment. You can't impose additional conditions and stop paying. You've got a big problem not reimbursing at this stage. The judge eventually held Mueller and the Department of Education in contempt of court for holding up applications for more feeding sites, a $35,000 fine plus $11,000 in legal costs.
This idea of going after MDE, why are you complaining at the police officer who made the arrest?
So it comes down to a distinction between an actual order and an implied directions from the judge. Judge Guthman did not issue a written order to MDE to resume the payments, but he did tell the state's lawyers multiple times in open court they lacked any legal basis for holding up the applications and payments, and they'd be held in contempt if they didn't comply with previous orders. And Kent, that's about the time that the Department of Education got the FBI involved, and this was all USDA federal money anyway, so they thought the FBI would be the best agency to go after this.
And John, with that amount of gray area, I'm guessing this is not the last we're going to hear of this, especially with an election coming up.
That is true. In fact, today, Scott Jensen called for the governor to appoint a special investigator to do an investigation and get that wrapped up October 17th, the day before the next debate.
That would be a tight timeline.
Would be.
All right. Thanks, John.